Hey my lovelies, welcome back to my channel. I want to welcome all my new subscribers. Thanks for being here, I appreciate you all. So today we're going to be doing yes or no question. So ask any question and we'll see whether it's a yes or a no. If you're drawn to more part another pile, you know, look at that as well. So for pile one we have amethyst. For pile two, we have blue howlite. Pile three, we have red jasper. And for pile four, we have fluorite. Okay, so take what resonates, leave what doesn't, don't force anything, and I'll see you at your piles. Hey group one, so if you chose amethyst, this is your reading. So I'm gonna start with, let's put down your tarot card. So we have the King of Wands, the Emperor, Queen of Wands, Six of Swords, the Devil. Okay, let's put down your oracle cards. We have respect, peace, fawns. Okay, wrong way. Peaceful resolution and no need to worry. And then we have the seed potential. Okay, so right off the bat here I'm seeing that the answer is a yes to your question. Okay, something's going on here with you group one. Something's going on with you here. You're being subjected to something here that's not good for you, okay? We've got the Devil here. It could be affecting your self-esteem. It could be affecting your life at the moment. And Spirit is trying to now get you to the stage where you're feeling strong and then you can say no, okay? Because maybe you feel like you can't say no to a certain situation or no to whatever it is that's going on with you, okay? Maybe you're too scared to say that. Maybe you don't have the confidence there. You know, Spirit is saying that maybe it's time to start reacting instead of avoiding it. Because if you were to react, you could end up, you know, smooth sailing. Or even a peaceful resolution here as well to whatever it is that's going on here. We have weathering the challenges ahead will bring a new positive future. So maybe it is that you want to say no more to maybe a relationship that you're in that's been toxic for you, because we do have the Devil. Maybe you're at this stage that enough is enough, okay? You just want a peaceful life. Because Spirit is saying there is a peaceful resolution here. There's peace here as well. There's time to respect yourself here as well. So it could be that maybe you've been going through this for the last 5 months, or you're going to continue to go through this until you get to the stage where you're feeling stronger to say no to something. Enough is enough for the next 5 months, okay? I'm being drawn to the King of Wands. Tell me about the King of Wands. You know, we have a couple here, okay? The King and Wands and the Queen of Wands is a couple, but if you actually look, your back is to the King of Wands and the Emperor here. So you could be dealing with a father figure as well as your partner here, okay? Or you could be dealing with a boss. Just somebody that's in authority here, that think they have power over you, okay? But tell me about the King of Wands. Page of Wands. The Sun. So you could be looking at, maybe you want a new career, you want a fresh start, maybe there's something going on at work here that you just feel really dissatisfied with it, okay? Maybe you get pushed around a lot, you know, maybe that is why you can't say no at times where you feel like you can't say no, but you can bloody well say no, okay? So we've got strong fire sign in this reading, Leo, Aries, Sagittarius. And Capricorn, but very strong fire sign here. You know, we have the Sun on the back of the deck. This is you being enlightened, standing in your power here, you know, becoming strong, healing from whatever it is that's going on here. Tell me more about this Page of Wands. King of Wands. This could even be you that you want to go back to school. This is a work situation here. It could be that you just want to move away from... I feel like the reason why your back is turned towards these two people here is because you just don't want to be in this environment no more. You don't have any, you're not gaining any respect from whoever it is that you're working with. And you've just had enough. The environment has become very toxic, okay? It's like you are being mistreated here. And you are a very hard worker. But I feel like these people take advantage of that. And you now want to move on. You know, the money is good and everything. But your emotional needs are not being met here. Tell me about this devil. Oh God. Six of Wands. Page of Pentacles. Yeah, look, you know what, guys. Spirit is saying that you're the one that's going to be coming out on top here, okay? Because we have the Six of Wands, which is victory and success. It's a new, you know, it's a fresh start. It's a new job. You know, we've got two job cards here. Well, actually three. I feel like you are the Emperor as well, guys. You are finally going to be standing up for yourself, because the Emperor is somebody that is, you know... someone in authority, or just takes charge of a situation or takes charge of their life, you know, stands up for themselves. You know, the Emperor, he's very powerful, very strong, okay? And Spirit's actually saying you are actually in control of this. You just need to stand up for yourself. Find your inner Emperor. Here is what Spirit is saying. You've got two news cards here, okay? Two, you know, communication cards here. So if it is that you're wanting to move jobs, you know, find a new career or just get away from these people, you're going to be receiving communication in regards to work here, and you're going to feel very happy, okay? And it is going to bring you success here. Because I feel like wherever it is that you are at the moment, you're not receiving any respect, and you do deserve respect. So it could be that you've been looking for about 5 months now, or in the next 5 months, you will move away from this situation here. Let's get some advice for you guys. What advice would you give group one? So the answer is yes to the question. Seven of Pentacles. What advice would you give group one? You know, Spirit is saying you just got to have patience. You've got to work hard, okay? You be patient at the moment. Maybe it's that you can't move forward yet, okay? Two of Pentacles. Nine of Pentacles again. You know, this is... Look... You're weighing up your options here. Should I stay? Should I go? Should I move on? Is it a risk? Do I do this? Do I not do this? This is what I keep seeing here, okay? You're very like, it's like, do I take that job? Do I not take that job? But you know the answer, okay? It could even be that you're being offered a job here and Spirit is saying you can say no. It could be a promotion because, you know, that is another option here as well, and you don't actually really want to take it because you're not happy there, because the environment is very unhealthy for you, okay? You can say no. But it is that you guys want to move on to somewhere where you are respected, where you are appreciated, where you, it brings you some inner peace here, okay? Spirit saying moving on is also very potential for you. You don't need to worry as well if you've been worrying about transferring or changing jobs here. You know, you are weighing up your options at the moment. And then you have the Nine of Pentacles again. This is you thriving, you know, doing very well financially. Enjoying the rewards. It will be rewarding, whatever it is that you move on to, okay? So any more advice for group one in regards to the yes or no question? Seven of Swords. Tell me about... Okay. Eight of Wands. Tell me about the Seven of Swords. Eight of Cups. Yes. Okay. Right. Spirit's advice to you. Okay. Look, we've got the Two of Wands as well. Seven of Swords is about being sneaky, okay? Trying to get away with something. You know, lying, stealing, cheating, all that. But with you guys, Spirit is saying to you... You need to be clever here when it comes to this situation, okay? Don't tell people what you're doing at work. Just be one step ahead of these people. You need to now be very clever and sneaky yourself, okay? The Eight of Wands is a communication, again, messages, something happening very quickly. So there is a lot of backwards and forwards communication here. So this is going to happen very quickly, and then it may be that you're going to have to make a decision quickly, okay? But Spirit doesn't want you to tell other people what you're doing, because it could end up holding you back. They could end up, you know, it could end up going wrong. Just keep it to yourself, okay? And it's time to walk away. The Eight of Cups, Seven of Swords, it's time for you to just turn your back on these people, turn your back on this whole situation here. Yes, you invested a long time into this, but you didn't receive any reward here, okay? So it's time to move on, is what Spirit is saying. Make that choice here with the Two of Wands. You have a decision to make, and listen to your intuition as well. It could be with that respect card there that your intuition is not being, you know, maybe it's laying dormant, maybe it's, you're just not listening to it at the moment, it's not guiding you correctly because you're all over the place at the moment. You know, you are making a choice and you are waiting at the moment. Maybe you're waiting to make that move. Maybe you're waiting to hear about a new job, but there is a lot of communication here, okay? And it is very positive here. So your answer is yes. So maybe you guys want to know whether you're going to get a new job or whether you're going to get that job offer. It's yes. Okay, so let me get a couple of oracle cards to go on top of that for you, group one. Worry. Spirit's saying no need to worry, okay? I am learning that worry doesn't change the outcome. Yes, stop worrying, okay? It's not going to change anything. I keep hearing Spirit saying, just relax. You're about to enter a phase here, you know, the Six of Swords is, it's a calm time that's ahead of you, okay? Like I said, you may have to go through it enough for another 5 months, or you've been going through it for 5 months. So just remember that 5 months, okay? So stop worrying. Happiness. I'm aware that being happy means that I'm on the right path. So yeah, you've, happiness is on its way to you guys, okay? You're going to feel so happy after all this, whatever you dealt with there. Obviously, the environment wasn't very nice. So, let's have a look. Angel message for you from your angels. Group one. So, you've got two messages. So, we have Astra. Astara, should I say. You deserve the best. Reach for the stars with your dreams and desires and don't compromise. There you go. Don't compromise, okay? Say no. In future as well, guys. You know, if you are one of these people that don't like to say no to people, don't like to let people down, you need to stand in your emperor power here, okay? The masculine side of yourself. And start standing up for yourself, start saying no. If things are, if people are pushing you about and taking advantage of you, don't let them do that no more. Okay? Then we have Caressa. You are at the end of a cycle in your life. Call upon your angels to comfort you and to guide you to your next step. Happiness awaits you now. Yes, you are at an end of a cycle here. This is a chapter that's about to close. You're leaving this behind. It's lovely. So let's get one of these. Book group one, please, Spirit. Don't even know what these cards are. We have Links, keeper of secrets. Take time out from the world and be the observer. Nothing can deceive you when you trust your knowing. And also, I said you needed to be sneaky here with the Seven of Swords, okay? Just don't reveal anything to anybody. Keep it to yourself. And yes, observe what's going on around you. Pay attention. You see others' secrets and keep them sacred. In silence and solitude, you will find your strength. Keep your secrets, guys. Even though it says you keep other people's secrets, but honestly, keep your own secrets here. Okay, don't. I'm hearing that quite strongly. Don't trust no one when it comes to the people in this environment, okay? No one. So group one, I'm going to leave it there. If you like this reading, please hit like, and I appreciate you. Much love, guys. Hey, group two. So if you chose How Light, this is your reading. So put down your tarot cards first. You got extra tarot cards, you did, you guys. So we have the Seven of Wands, Six of Wands, Strength, the Hermit, Ace of Pentacles, Five of Wands, Four of Wands, and then we have Family. Wish, your heart's desire is ready to come true. Children, family, children, wow, okay. Within the next few months, okay. Just put that there. The engine, cooperation. Your the question that you've asked group two is yes, okay? And I'm hearing don't give up now. Keep going, okay? Things have been hard, but do not give up. You're about to succeed in I'm getting, look, sensitive subject. I hate, honestly, one of the worst things I hate doing in a, as a tarot reader, and I avoid it as much as I can. I don't even do it with my personal readings. It's actually stated I will not do anything to do with health, and I will not do anything to do with children, okay, pregnancies, because it is just such a sensitive subject, okay? Now, I am getting this very strongly here that what you've been waiting for is to start a family, okay? And I'm getting it very strongly here. You've gone through a lot here, and spirit is saying, don't give up yet. Okay, you've been waiting, 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 waiting. That's what I keep hearing. And this is your heart's desire here with this wish card. You've got children here that have come out, literally, family children. So you've obviously wanted to start a family. Maybe it's not happened because there's been some setbacks here, maybe some problems in regards to that. But Spirit is saying you're about to succeed. I mean, we've even got within the next few months for you guys. And you know what? I'm seeing this. I know this sounds very weird. Oh, guys, but looking at this card here with the engine. I'm taking this as like your body parts, okay? That maybe just your body part wasn't ready to cooperate at the time when you were trying, and now your engine is about to cooperate, if you know what I mean. I hope you understand what I'm trying to say by this card here. Everything's going to start kicking into gear, okay? So don't give up, is what Spirit is saying. Keep going. And you are somebody that is very, very strong here with the strength card. You have inner strength, you have outer strength. You know, it could be that you're hiding the hurt from people. You feel like maybe you need to put on a brave face with around certain people here. You know, maybe you don't want to show that it's been hurting you. And this desire to start a family, you've been hiding that from a lot of people. I feel like you're just like, I feel like you've got to the stage where you're so fed up with people asking you that you may have told people you've stopped or you're not trying anymore, you know, because you just don't want people to keep asking you, okay? Because it's taken a lot of strength for you to not break down. And with the Ace of Pentacles, this is beautiful, okay? This is a new beginning here, something that's gonna blossom. You know, it's family, it's buying a home, it's moving away, you know, it's all that that comes with it. It's just pure abundance here. But don't give up, is what Spirit is saying. You're about to succeed, okay? Even with this card here, your heart's desire is ready to come true. You know, with the Five of Wands here, this is just things that are out of your control, okay? Outside influences, you know, that, you know, when it comes to problems with the body and what have you, it's out of your control. There's nothing you can actually do about it. But what is so beautiful to see is the Four of Wands. This is starting a family, okay? It's birth, weddings, buying a home again, but obviously it's leaning more towards the family side of things. You know, this is a celebration here, a celebration of a birth, a pregnancy. It's very, very, very positive, group two, okay? And Spirit is saying in the next few months. So I'm not going to look into no more of this because I'm very happy about what I'm seeing here. And the answer is yes for you guys. So I'm going to get you some oracle cards, okay? I know that was quick and short, but I really don't want to mess with it. like I said, don't really like to look into things like this. I'll take what spirit's given me here and we'll just go from there. So for group two spirit, what more do they need to know? Death. I'm learning that endings are merely a beginning. So, you know, this could be an end to the waiting, okay? The end to the pain and suffering that you've been going through. It's finally over with death. Doesn't mean someone's going to die or anything like that. It means like a new phase in life, okay? Big changes are about to happen for you. So let's get another one. Look, I'm going to take that. They did flip over. Perseverance. I know that I can do whatever I set my mind to. Keep going. So I said about the first card there. Don't give up. Look. Surrender. I can release my need to control. And do you know what that looks like? I hope you ladies, if you're watching this, or men, you know, that really looks like an egg with a load of, you know what I'm on about. I've got to keep it clean on YouTube. That really does look like that. So it's just surrender, release that control. I feel like you have, though, with the Hermit here. I feel like you're just leaving it up to whoever, you know, the universe, your spirit guides, your ancestors, your angels. You're just like, now, you know what, I release it to you. So let's get some messages from your angels, okay? I thought this is important for you guys, group two. So, too many spirit. Oh, okay. We have Isabella. Yes, the timing is right for this new venture. Happy outcome follows your positive expectations. Beautiful. Okay. Let's get one more for you. Bridget. Caution is warranted. Look deeper into this situation before proceeding any further. Yeah, maybe you need to bridge it here. I don't know what I'm hearing. It's like I feel like you guys just want to give up. Maybe you've decided to do something here that spirit is saying, don't do it yet, look into it before you act, okay? So that there is a warning there, guys. So whatever it is that you are thinking about, look into the situation before. Maybe you want to take an alternative route, you know, alternative medicine or something like that. Please do some homework before you go down that road, okay? So there is a little bit of a warning there from your angels. Let's get one of these for you, for group two. We have Dear Love. Be gentle with yourself. You heal with the power of love. See the light in all things. Acknowledge your self-worth and grace. Maybe you feel, group two, that maybe you feel less than, and spirit is saying, don't do that, okay? Be gentle with yourself. Stop giving yourself a hard time. Love yourself, okay? And then we have Wolf, Pathfinder. Release your past and start a new journey. You are a teacher and help others find their way. There will be challenges, but your soul is strong. Perseverance is your secret power. You have love that endures. See, look, persevere. We've literally had that perseverance and perseverance right here, guys. Keep going. Don't give up, okay? So group two, I'm going to leave it there. That was a beautiful reading. If you like this video, please hit like. Much love, guys. Hey, group three. So if you chose the red jasper, this is your reading. So let's lay down your tarot cards first. If I can get it up, I bloody cut my nails. Tarot cards first. So we have the Ace of Cups, Page of Swords, Three of Cups, the Sun. It's definitely a yes to whatever it is that you asked here. Then we have Courage, Judgment. Soul searching will bring inner peace to many areas of your life. Education, Weight, the Clock, Nostalgia. So the answer is yes. Just bear with me, guys. You know, the Page of Swords is, you know, learning about something here. You know, then we've got soul searching, then we've got the Hangman. That is soul searching as well, you know, it's going within. Group three, you're always bloody complicated, honestly. I need to look at this more. The answer is yes, but what's it yes to? Tell me about this Page of Swords and this Three of Cups. Keep being drawn to those two. Ten of Wands. Three of Wands is yearning. It's like nostalgia again. The World. Sorry about this Ace of Cups. Bear with me, guys. Queen of Wands. Oh, okay. I see what it is. I'm hearing very strongly here third party or somebody else, okay? There's somebody you want to be with here. Someone, whether you want to know whether this person, what's the word, returns your feelings, okay? The answer is yes. But the problem is, this person's stuck in a third party situation here. There's somebody else here. You know, You know, maybe you just wanted to know whether this person returns, you know, shares the same feelings here, whether it's whether it's returned, okay? Yes, it is. And I feel like just knowing this, okay, will actually heal you, you know, would make you feel better. You've been stressed, you've been worried, it's like you're waiting. We've got nostalgia. Look, the clock as well. Three of Wands. It's waiting for someone. It's pining. It's that yearning for something to happen or someone to return here. And with education here, I'm not seeing that it's anything to do with learning. I'm seeing it as you're seeing the truth finally, okay? Because the Page of Swords is finding out information. It's also online, you know, spying online. We also got the World here, which is also computers, you know, looking online. Also, it can be something that's finally coming to a close. You know, a lesson learned, and then, you know, you can close that door. So we've got Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. We've got Leo, Aries, Sagittarius as well. You know, you're trying to be strong about this situation. You're trying to have confidence, you know, you're trying to be very positive about it. But it's like, I don't know. Tell me more about this situation. Justice, judgment as well. Justice and judgment. So we have Libra. So you're having this wake up call. Tell me more about the situation for group three. Five of Pentacles. The Tower. Yeah, look. So the question could have been, do I walk away? Do I wait? You know, that kind of question is what I'm seeing here for you guys, okay? Obviously, I don't know what the question is, but that's from what I'm getting from the cards. It's something to do with love. Something to do with somebody that you have feelings for. You may want to know whether this person returns those feelings. The answer is yes, but there is a problem. There's a situation outside of your control here. This is... I feel like you're healing from it, or you're about to heal from it, okay? And I feel like walking away from this person, it took a lot of courage to do that. But you had to do what was right for you with justice here, okay? You can't let this situation keep going on, okay? We have the Five of Pentacles, which speaks about leaving somebody out in the cold, okay? Walking away from someone. Or just some, you know, a situation going cold. And then we have the Tower here, which is all about talking about this was a rocky foundation, okay? There wasn't anything solid here when it came to this situation. maybe the reason why, you know, you've asked the question is maybe this is what you want to do, how you want to react, but there is that card there that says wait. Just wait. Why is this card wait here? You know, because the Ace of Cups, it does talk about a second chance, you know, hope, love, relationships, marriage. Why should group three wait? Knight of Pentacles, bloody hell. This is, you've been waiting for a long time. You've been literally waiting, waiting. Because the Knight of Pentacles is somebody that is so slow. Because they want to make the right decision. You know, this is not somebody that rushes into anything. They like to weigh up the pros and cons. So you have been waiting for a long time. Tell me more. Why is this wait here? We've got Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. Two of Cups. Wait. King of Swords. Ten of Swords. Eight of Cups. Okay. Look, Spirit's saying you've been waiting for a long time. Okay? That's why that wait's there. It doesn't mean that you need to wait. It means that Spirit is literally saying, we've got two wait cards here. You've been waiting for so long. You see this person as your soulmate here. You do love this person. You feel like you had this beautiful connection with them. But this person has literally shown you no love here, okay? It's I feel like it has been one-sided for whoever, you know, this resonates with. It's been one-sided. This person has not expressed their feelings to you, okay? And maybe you just want to know, do they feel the same way? Yes, they do. I'm seeing that very strongly here, okay? You brought some kind of healing toward, you know, for them as well. You made them happy. That's what they want to say here. But as I said, outside forces, like, you know, it's outside of your control here. Ten of Swords is the ultimate betrayal, okay? It's a painful ending. Eight of Cups, walking away, having to leave it behind. You know, someone that's withdrawn from you, okay? So I feel like I'm picking up strong gaslighting here as well. I just keep hearing you didn't get any closure. They literally just went cold on you. I mean, because the King of Swords and the Five of Pentacles and then the Eight of Cups here, this is like someone that literally just done a runner. So the answer is yes to whatever it is that you were asking. And I do feel as strongly believe the answer is, did they even care about you? Yes, they did. And if you want to know, this person still watches you, okay? They haven't let go. That, you know, they still spy on you to see what you're doing. So let's get some advice cards for you, group three. Courage. You literally, look at this, guys, you can't make this crap up. You've literally got two cards that says courage here. Find the inner strength to face the fear with confidence, okay? You know, some of you may not want to walk away. You may not want to wait. This person keeps hurting you if they are still in contact with you. That could be the answer there. Should you walk away? Have the courage to do it, you know? Because you're always going to be waiting, guys. Where is it? Was it on the back of the deck? No, it's here. You're always going to be waiting. You're always going to be wondering. Okay? Okay, it's very sad. I feel sad. for you. Self-esteem. I possess gifts of the soul that benefit me and others. You know, it could be that your self-esteem's taken a knock, okay? You're suffering with a bit of low self-esteem. Maybe you feel like you're just not worth it, but that's not true, guys, okay? So let's get a message from your angels to you. So group three. What message do the angels want to give? Oh, you got three. Group three, three. Oh, I thought that was funny anyway. I'm so sad. So we've got Indriel. You are the light worker. God needs you to shine your divine light and love like an angel upon the earth and all of its inhabitants. So maybe your light's being dimmed because of this situation here, you know. Yeah, I feel like your self-esteem and your inner light has just been dimmed by this situation here. Then we have Seraphina. I am an angel of families. A happy change or addition is coming to your family. So, you know, she's holding a baby. Maybe some of you might be expecting soon. Maybe you will end up getting pregnant. So just be careful. There might be a bit of a warning there. Or it could just be, you know, maybe someone that you know is about to have a baby and it's going to bring about positive change. Maybe you'll start like, I don't know, maybe this child is a gift to you, even though it may not be your child. Maybe it's going to make you feel that the child is going to make you feel happy. Something special about a child that's going to be born here. And then we've got Crystal. Have faith and hope, because there is something positive and new on the horizon that you can't see yet. Yes, so this can be a second chance at love here for you, okay? A new romance here with the Ace of Cups. You're going to meet someone that you are going to fall in love with, and it can even be your soulmate as well. I mean, maybe this is a false, it could be a karmic here that you've dealt with here, a false soulmate, because we do have justice here. Let's get an advice card here. Group three, please, spirit. Lynx, keeper of secrets. Take time out for the world and be the observer. Nothing can deceive you when you trust your knowing. You see other secrets and keep them sacred. In silence and solitude, you will find your strength. Yeah, I feel like this has been a bit huge secret for you, and you've kept it hidden from people. You know, you've not let the cat out of the bag here, because you're one of these people that can be trusted. You don't go after like for revenge or being petty. And I feel like you do hold this secret close to your heart, okay? And I don't feel like anybody really knows about it. So, I'm going to leave it there, group three. If you like this reading, please hit like, and I'll see you soon. Bye. Hey, group four. So, if you chose, I've forgotten what this one is called anyway, the green one. Just ignore me. Oh, God. Right, let's get your tarot cards. So, we have the Princess of Wands, which is the Page of Wands. The Hermit, the Empress, the Tower, Three of Wands. Bear with me. A consciousness of lack. Mountain, know that you are protected as you face challenges, but remain cautious. Submission, opportunity, and the dagger, protection. Okay, I am getting strongly here that the answer is maybe no. It's like a no and a yes. Actually, let's go with a maybe. I know that's not really helping you guys, but your energy at the moment is all over the place, group four. It's like you're not, this is, you're not submitting to something, okay? You're not facing something. It's like your intuition is blocked here, okay? It's like your spirit guides can't hear you. Because of this situation here, you've got a blockage. And I keep hearing you lot saying, I can't take this anymore. I don't want to do it. I don't understand. It's unfair. You've been yearning for something here, waiting for something, but it's not happening. Spirit is saying maybe you need to go within, okay? You need to take a good hard look at the situation here. You are the divine feminine, okay? But you're out of sync with your femininity here, okay? Because the Empress, she is someone that is very solid, very grounded. You know, she knows her mind. She knows what she wants. You know, you're very, the Empress is very successful. And it's like you've got it's like you guys are on this mountain. I have cards like this. I forgot what they're called, the Normand. And we have a mountain card in that deck. And it's like something that is something that you've been climbing for so long, but it's just like you can't seem to reach the top. And maybe you just need to submit now, like, you know, and decide, well, not decide, just face the truth that it may never happen, okay? And, you know, I don't want to be a negative Nelly, but the good thing about this, you've got the opportunity here, which, you know, sometimes things don't work out the way we want them to work out, and it takes us in a different direction, okay? Which brings about opportunities, you know, something that is totally different. And this is what spirit is saying, they're not hearing you at the moment, your spirit guides, because you're not submitting. Maybe it's because you're being very stubborn about this, okay? Maybe you're not seeing the signs. You're like, well, why am I not manifesting anything? Why am I not seeing any signs? They are giving you signs, but you're just not listening, okay? I want to clarify this tower. Tell me about the tower, please, spirit. For group four. I don't know whether I said group three, so I do apologize because I don't usually do four piles. Two of swords, four of cups, ten of wands. Yeah, you're going for a hard time, group four. Look, this is something that is, look, the mountain again with the Ten of Wands. It's just, I don't know, something that's in just not able to overcome here. You've just caused yourself a lot of burdens. Whatever it is that you're asking about is too much for you, okay? It's time to compromise, is what spirit is saying here. It's time to balance things out now, okay? You may need to sacrifice something here to get to become balanced again, okay? You may need to reject an idea that you've had, or I feel like you just need to reject something here. It's not bringing you any satisfaction. It's only bringing you a lot of problems here with the Ten of Wands. And if you do not reject this, or you know, walk away from it, it could cause a tower moment in your life, okay? Or it is causing tower moments in your life. It could be affecting your life quite a lot. You are in this state of mind of, it's not fair, I don't get it, why is it not happening? You know, all those things that we ask ourselves, there's nothing wrong with that. But Spirit's saying, if you go within, take some time out, spend some time alone, you will find the answer. So what advice would you give Group 4? Okay. Page of Swords. What advice would you give Group 4? You know, with this dagger protection here, I feel like you've got no protection at the moment, okay? That's how I'm seeing that card. And you need to protect yourself from outside forces, okay? Three of Pentacles. So this could be a work thing, okay? Seven of Wands. You're being very stubborn. So there could be a lot of gossip surrounding you at the moment. Or it could just be that you need to admit the truth to you with the Page of Swords here. Maybe you've tried to get involved with other people to work with you. Maybe an idea that you've had here, but it's not working. Okay? Maybe you need to go and, I don't know, get help from outside, someone else outside of the people that you know, to help you work this out. But you also need to be careful, because this is a spying card, okay? And then you have the Three of Pentacles. So it could be maybe things are not working out because you have spies. People you can't trust. It's like competition here. There's a big, whatever it is that you're wanting to do, that there is a big, big, big competition in regards to what it is that you want, okay? It's just like what I'm doing here. The competition on YouTube is bloody, like, you know, it is what it is. You either can keep going or give up. So what should Group 4 do, Spirit? King of Cups. Ten of Wands again, guys. King of Cups, Queen of Cups in reverse, and the Nine of Pentacles. So it could be that you're not getting on with people. If you are working with other people, okay, if this is some kind of small business or an idea, something here, you're dealing with somebody that can be, is very greedy, okay? It's causing a lot of problems for you here, okay? Whoever this is, the Queen of Cups in reverse, I mean, it could even be you, is causing problems for you with the Ten of Wands. This is like having no trust in this person. You can't trust this Queen of Cups in reverse. So we've got Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Yeah, Aries, Sagittarius, Virgo. Right, hang on. Tell me about the Queen of Cups in reverse. It's you. You are the Queen of Cups in reverse. You're very ungrounded at the moment. I'm seeing you as the King of Cups as well as the Queen of Cups, okay? You have two sides to you, okay? And your other side seems to be taking over and affecting you here. And with the High Priestess here, you're not listening to your intuition. You're not using the gifts that were given to you, because the High Priestess is very gifted spiritually. You know, Spirit is saying, and I know this sounds really horrible, Group 4, but I'm just going to say it, that you're becoming very whiny. You know, it's a lot of woe is me. You need to trust yourself. Then we have the Nine of Pentacles here. It could be you, you know, you are single for some of you here. You're very successful. Or you'll want to be successful, okay? Maybe you want to branch out on your own if it is working with other people here. Oh. Tell me about the Nine of Pentacles, please. Maybe you know, some of you, okay, because there's a lot of people that watch these readings. It could be maybe you're asking that whether you should, like, go off on your own. Ten of Cups. Okay, I'm actually seeing this as a relationship as well. There's another side to this reading as well that is in regards to actually a relationship here. So it could be that your partner is the whiny one. The partner is the one that's very insecure, very needy, very demanding. Okay, you are the King of Cups, where you are, you know, balanced. You're very caring, you're very loving, because you did come out as the Empress here. But you've got a person here that is so draining, okay? Draining. So this can be business, this can be a relationship, okay? Your intuition is telling you what to do here, but you're just not listening to it. It could be maybe you want to be single, but you're not sure whether you want to be on your own. You know, you could have a family with this person, because, you know, the Empress is a mother, father, doesn't matter, it's energies. You've put in a lot of effort into this relationship, a connection, even with a business partnership. It doesn't matter. Take what resonates. You've invested a long time with this person, but you're starting to see the truth for what it is. It's starting to, you know, it's staring you in the face, and it's time to make that decision. Do you go off on your own? Do you stay? So if it's to do with work, you know, you need to come to a decision there. If it's to do with a relationship, then, you know, the truth is being shown to you here and what to do. So what more advice would you give Group 4? Five of Pentacles in reverse. Nine of Swords in reverse. This is a good sign. So, you know, finances are going to start improving, okay? It could be that maybe your resources are being drained by the person that you're with, or by, you know, maybe, like, you don't want to share the wealth anymore. You want to go off on your own, okay? Finances are about to improve. There's a light at the end of the tunnel here with the Five of Pentacles in reverse. you're going to start feeling confident and happy. Yeah, end of hardships here. Finances are improving. Light at the end of the tunnel here. But that's if you take action, okay, guys? You know, the answer was no. So maybe you're asking whether you should stay in this collaboration here or with a partner here. I'm seeing it's more work than it is anything else. Like, I don't know, you've started some kind of business here and it's just like Princess of Page of Pentacles in reverse. It's just not working out. You know, this is money problems, business problems. So yeah, it's just literally going down the same route here. You know, judgment, make that decision. It's your call at the end of the day. Okay, so let's get you some oracle cards here for group four. Oh, Jesus. Okay. Gratitude. I am thankful for this life and the opportunities that it presents. You've got opportunity there and you've got opportunities here. So, you know, maybe you were given an opportunity and it didn't work out, okay? And Spirit's saying, just be grateful. You know, take that as a life lesson. You know, because sometimes when things don't work out, there's better opportunities around the corner. Honesty. I can't always expect the truth from others, but I can expect it from myself. Yes, and this is what you're not facing here, group four. You're not listening to yourself. You're not being honest with yourself. Purpose. I know what I am here to do. Yeah, so you know your life purpose, you know what you need to do, but just maybe you guys are very stubborn. Okay, so let's get some messages from your angels. We have Crystal. Have faith and hope because there is something positive and new on the horizon that you can't see yet. Yeah, exactly. There is something very positive. Then we have Aurora. You are flying high right now, which may threaten others, but don't descend because others will soon become inspired by your example. Okay, so I take that as you flying solo, okay? Like you're about to take flight in regards to whatever is going on here. I mean, maybe you're being, you know, manipulated into staying and you don't really want to stay. It's just like you're all over the place. I feel confused with you guys doing this reading. It's like you just don't know what to do. Oh God, my dog's got on one. So let's get one more message. Okay, I'm going to take them. They're very weird. So let's see. We've got B community. You are a powerful creator. Your work blesses everything you touch. Be open to receiving sweetness. You are a queen of abundance. You are. You know, and it could be maybe someone's not listening to your ideas. Maybe you can't expand. Maybe you can't grow. Maybe you feel just stuck. It's just that all that, you know, like when I said at the beginning, like, why is this happening? Why me? You know, this, that, the other. Spirit saying you are a very powerful creator here. And if it means you going off on your own, doing it alone with the Nine of Pentacles here, it's going to be very rewarding financially, okay? Then you have Fox, clever. You are swift and smart, solutions to problems and easily found. Always listen to your instincts, resources surround you. Be open to romance, okay? But you may need to be sly. You need to meet, you know, because the fox is sly, the fox is very, very clever, okay? Maybe you need to become a bit like a fox. Hummingbird, miracles. You are the joy bringer. You bless the world, positivity and love. Energy soars on your shining wings. Spread the miracle of happiness. Yeah, look, now that really does clarify the Empress, okay? She's very abundant, you know. You are love and light, basically. But I feel like your love, your light is being dimmed here, because we've got the Hermit as well. And, you know, like I said, maybe you guys have become the whingers. Not me, like I said, I didn't mean that in any disrespectful way. But we do get to that stage. I mean, come on, I've even bloody well done it. You know, when you're sitting there and you're like, oh, for God's sake, why me? You know, it's all that woe is me. And then you snap out of it. And you're like, for God's sake, stop feeling sorry for yourself. Get off your ass and do something about it. And that's what spirit wants you to do here. Get off your bum, follow your dreams, stop waiting for it to happen here with the Three of Wands. You know, if you have to cause a tower moment in your life here, if you have to break things up here and cause tower moments in other people's lives, you've got to do what you've got to do sometimes. You know, you've got to be selfish if it brings you happiness. So don't hold back with whatever it is that you're wanting to do here. So I'm going to leave it here, group four. If you like this reading, please hit like. And you have a lovely Sunday. Much love, guys.